Hi, I'm Lowell Martin, and this is MCC Today. Get ready to learn something. On today's show, we have Aisha Robertson, Elizabeth Borders, and Susan Johnson. We'll have a lot of information for you, and it's all really good stuff. Stay tuned.
Find your wings. It's more than just a hashtag.
It's the power of knowledge in our state-of-the-art classrooms.
It's skills training for a competitive job market.
It's the best nursing program in the state.
It's home runs, buzzer beaters, and the thrill of victory.
And MCC walks it off.
It's not just a hashtag. How do I know? Because I found my wings.
And we are here with the wonderful Miss Elizabeth Borders. How are you doing today?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm doing well. I say you're the wonderful. I know you are. But you are the Meridian Classical. You're at the Meridian Classical Center for Learning.
Yes, sir.
What is that?
We are a two-day-a-week homeschool enrichment program. We service, all homeschoolers, whether it be this county. We've got some from Newton County, various counties.
Okay. Now, is there, you said all homeschoolers, so any mm-hmm. age group from, kindergarten through senior or 12th grade?
Our program actually starts all the way from K-3.
Okay.
And we go through 10th grade.
Okay. Okay. Mm-hmm. And what type of things do you offer?
All your basic core subjects, language arts, science, history. We also offer Spanish, PE, music, and art.
Okay. What would draw parents to homeschool their children, if you don't mind me asking? There are many reasons, but...
It could be a lot of things. Personally, for me, when I have four children ranging in ages from 22 to 10 now, and what drew me into homeschooling was I was pulled into our public school system and wanted to serve there as a mentor and a volunteer, so on and so forth. And I just didn't like what I saw, and I felt like my children needed a little bit more than what they were getting. And of course, it's a personal choice for everybody.
Sure.
Homeschooling is not for everybody. We don't feel like we're better than anybody. It's just something different for every family. And that's kind of, you have to do what you have to do for your children. Right now, Meridian Classical is receiving a lot of phone calls. When COVID hit a couple years back, we saw a very big increase in homeschooling. Mm-hmm. The virtual learning was not working for a lot of students. And so we started receiving a lot of phone calls. Parents needed help.
Mm-hmm.
And homeschooling was new to them. And once it was all said and done, we saw a very large number of families actually stay with homeschooling because they enjoyed it so much.
Well, that I found when mine went to virtual learning that you do need a lot more guidance.
Yes.
In it's just like, okay, have them do this, and many parents are not prepared and don't know how to help them do this, whether it be with math or science or anything like that. I was lucky in that I had a good background and was able to, stand over mine and, help them with it and say, okay, no, this is how you do it.
Oh, sure.
But a lot of parents were left, kind of without resources, unfortunately.
Well, and I feel that parents are the most capable person on the planet. I don't care who you are.
Mm-hmm.
You know your child best. You
mm-hmm.
know what their strengths are, their weaknesses are. And as far as their education goes, you're the best person
mm-hmm.
for them. I doubted myself a lot when I started homeschooling my own children, but you know, now I'm where I'm at. And we live in an age where everything is at our fingertips. Mm-hmm. You know, if they don't get something that, you know, they're reading out of a book, that, you know, for math, they can go to Khan Academy or, you know, mm-hmm. there's so many supplemental things that they can do nowadays. I mean, we're very fortunate to have that.
Yes, yes. Now, how did you ensure that, or how does a parent who homeschools their children ensure that their children are getting the necessary education, whether, you know, to move on, whether it be to college or directly into the workforce? How do you ensure that?
That's a really big question. And everybody does it a little differently, and it's really kind of according, again, to your student. The nice thing is, like I said, everything's at your fingertips, so all you have to do is get in Department of Education for the state of Mississippi, mm-hmm. and they outline everything that they are teaching their students in our public school system. Mm-hmm. So if a homeschool parent has a question about, well, I wonder if I've hit everything I need to hit for my child to move on from high school to college, It's right there at their fingertips.
Okay.
That was my first go-to. I now have a 16-year-old that is attending Mississippi School of the Arts in Brookhaven.
Oh, wonderful.
That's what she decided to do for her junior and senior year. And so through that process, you know, I had to make sure she was getting the courses she was supposed to get. Mm-hmm. And that's your first go-to.
Did she find the transition from homeschool to going to the Mississippi, going to that school, was it a difficult transition for her?
Well, sure. I feel like that would be a difficult transition for any child,
sure.
whether they're in a public school or not.
Living away from home and things
like that. Yeah, she's living away from home now. But, you know, she also attended Meridian Classical, and she was there 2 days a week, and she was prepared to enter a college setting, and we had prepared her for that.
Mm-hmm.
And so I feel like, you know, every kid, that's going to be a huge adjustment, but she's adjusted well and she's doing great.
Now, do you encourage do y'all encourage students to take advantage of like dual enrollment and things like that that we offer here at Meridian Community College?
Absolutely. That is part of the reason Meridian Classical only goes through 10th grade.
Okay.
So that would be obviously their sophomore year.
Mm-hmm.
Generally speaking, in your sophomore year of high school, you're going to be taking your ACT. You're going to be doing a lot of, you know, essay writing and college preparatory things already in your sophomore year. Most homeschoolers, and at least mine, by the time they're in their sophomore year, really should only have like a few credits left,
right?
In order to graduate high school. So what we do is we work through them through 10th grade, we get them prepped and ready to go, and by their junior and senior year, they're able to take dual enrollment classes here, or they can go to MSMS, mm-hmm. you know, or they can go to MSA. They have all these options before them. But dual enrollment, you know, we encourage that a lot because that's a good transition. You're not just plucked from high school and popped into a college setting, which we both know is a huge difference,
sure.
one between the other.
Sure.
This way they're able to transition, you know, comfortably and kind of slide into that slot in a more mm-hmm. comfortable manner. They, with dual enrollment, they get an idea of
yes.
what their expectations are for college and what they're going to have to do.
Okay. Now, if a parent is interested in homeschooling their children and they literally have no idea where to begin,
mm-hmm.
what would you recommend for them to do?
Google is your friend.
Okay. Yes, it
yes.
is.
The resources that we have out there are overwhelming, whether it be from curriculum to, you know, whether you decide if you want to do, you know, online or if you want to do part online and then part out of books. It's really according to your child's learning style.
Mm-hmm.
So I would say the first step you need to take is figure out what your child's learning style is.
Mm-hmm.
Are they auditory learner? Are they more hands-on? Are they a combination of things? And then you put it together that way. So
mm-hmm.
you are going to model it around your child's learning style.
Okay. This is fascinating to me, and I would like to have you on again to talk about this some more, if you don't mind.
Sure.
I would appreciate it greatly.
But yeah.
Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
Meridian Community College. For more than 75 years, we've helped students soar. Establishing the first tuition guarantee program in Mississippi, we put our students first while creating pathways into the workforce and offering a seamless transition to a 4-year degree. Now is the time to find your purpose and register today, because those who move forward never get left behind. MCC, find your wings.
And we are here with Miss Aisha Robertson. Yes. How are you doing?
Welcome back. I'm good. Thank you.
Sometimes it takes a while to get you on the show.
Well, I don't mind being here, so it's fine.
all of your area, I swear, and I love you guys so much, but all of your area, the first reaction is no.
Well, I asked to be on here today.
Yes,
so
you did.
It's fine.
You did. So I appreciate that. I appreciate that. And a couple of others from your area have asked to be on the show.
Okay, well, great.
So in the next couple of weeks. Yes. Now, you are the dual education coordinator
Correct.
Here for Meridian Community College. Mm-hmm. What exactly does that mean?
So dual education, our program helps high school students get enrolled in college courses a little bit early while they're still in high school.
Yes. But they did not have this program when I was going.
I know, you said that last time.
Every time, it really grates me.
I know, but it's great for high school students because they can take a class and they're getting high school credit and the college credit. They're getting it out the way and they're getting it at a discounted price of $50, which is great for students and I know parents.
Yes.
And it's really just a great program we have here, and we have it through academic, we have it through CTE. So it's available to all juniors, all seniors in high school. If they're doing CTE, it's available to sophomores as well. And it's really just a great way to jumpstart, you know, your college career.
So if you are interested in dual enrollment, mm-hmm. How do you begin the process of getting into a class?
You can do it one or two ways. You can go to our website. We have just enormous amount of information on our MCC website under dual education. Or if they're at a local high school, they can contact their counselor and let them know that they're interested, and they get that student in contact with me. Mm-hmm. I like to think I serve as the advisor for all of the high school students when it comes to dual credit. So they go through their counselor, and then their counselor directs them to me. And I help them get applied and get registered. And it's an easy step process. It's like three steps. You do an admissions application, you decide what classes you want to take, and then you fill out the dual credit form, and that's it. And then from there, I get you registered.
Excellent. Mm-hmm. Now, how old, you said that they have to be in the 11th grade?
They do.
Unless it's the workforce area.
Correct.
Right?
So if they want to do academic dual credit, which is our basic general education classes, so that's anything like English Comp 1, college algebra.
Study skills.
Yes. they have to be a junior or a senior in high school with a 3.0 GPA or higher.
Okay.
And of course, they have to have ACT test scores.
Okay.
If they want to do career in technical dual credit, they have to be a sophomore, junior, or senior, and they have to have a 2.0 or higher.
If they don't happen to have their ACT scores, can they take the ACCUPLACER?
They can. We do offer the ACCUPLACER here. It's free the first time you take it. It's $10 every time after that. But to my understanding, it's not a very hard test. It's a little bit more stress-free than the ACT, and a lot of students take it when they don't have the ACT scores, or if they don't have any scores at all, they take it, and then we're able to get them in those classes.
Okay. And are there just specific classes that dual enrollment can take, or is it open to any of the classes that we offer?
So it depends. If it's a dual credit, it's specific classes.
Okay.
If it's a dual enrollment, it can be any classes.
I would be so confused.
And I'll specify which is which.
Okay.
Dual credit is for our students that are located within Lauderdale County, and they are eligible to get that discount, that class at the discounted price of $50.
Okay.
Dual enrollment are our students that are outside of Lauderdale County.
Okay.
And they pretty much have to pay full price for the classes, unfortunately, but they are still able to get that college credit for that class, and it can be any class we offer here at MCC.
How many classes can they take for dual enrollment or dual credit?
For dual credit, it's two classes per semester.
Okay.
So we're actually about to end our fall semester going into our spring semester.
Okay.
So if they're taking two classes now, they can also take two classes in the spring.
So that's two classes to get the $50.
Right. Two classes per semester, $50 per class.
Could they opt to take another class but just take it full price?
They can. You can take any additional class after the two classes will be charged at full price.
Okay. Does that include summers? Can they take two classes in the summers as well?
That does include summer. The only thing we have to be cautious about when we're advising those high school students is to not go over a certain amount of credit hours so that when they do graduate from high school, they're still eligible for freshman scholarships once they attend MCC or any other college they plan to attend.
Okay. But what if someone really wanted to, and this has happened, I remember it a number of years ago, it was about, I think, 3 years ago possibly, where a student graduated from a local high school and he graduated in May and then at the end of August graduated from here.
That's totally possible. We do have some high school students that are just overachievers, and if they would like to do that, they can.
But they might not be eligible for some of the scholarships.
They won't, right. If you exceed 30 hours, you are no longer considered a freshman. You are considered a sophomore in college.
And but there is nothing wrong with being an overachiever.
There is nothing wrong with being an overachiever. You can definitely be an overachiever. There may come a time, if you took that many hours, I would foresee that you would be paying full price for some classes at some point in time in your dual credit, you know, program.
But you're still
But there's nothing wrong with that. You're
two
still
of those
getting
classes
your,
are going to be taking just $50.
They are, and you're still getting your college credits for it, so there's absolutely nothing wrong
with about that. Textbooks for those classes?
Textbooks are not included in the $50 price.
So you'll still have to?
Correct. The $50 price is solely for the class, which is the tuition part of it.
Okay.
Any additional fees, textbook fees, are totally separate, and they do have to pay those separate. Some classes have them, some do not. It just depends on the class. It depends on if it's an online class, if it's a science class that might have a lab attached to it.
Okay.
It's just, they're all different.
So students can now, you know, at our local high schools, if you're in the 11th grade or higher, you can begin the process of signing up for spring.
Correct.
Okay.
Registration is open.
Yes.
I've already been out to some of the local high schools, you know, helping and getting students applied.
You find a lot of interest? Are they interested
in
doing this?
Surprisingly, I do. Not, I say surprisingly, but you know, when you're in high school, you just don't, you're not thinking about that stuff necessarily. You're just, you know, you're in high school, you're getting ready to graduate, you're kind of having fun. So I'm really proud of those high school students. They're taking initiative and they're getting in these classes. We have over, we had over 200 students in dual credit this academic dual credit this fall, and over 250 in CTE this fall.
I find more and more students are able to get their prerequisites out of the way, like if they want to go into nursing or
they
want to go into, they're able to get those prerequisites out of the way using dual credit.
Exactly.
And so when they graduate, that the beginning in the fall, you know, they have to get
in
the program, they are completely ready.
That is, and that's just one of the benefits of it, you know, and that's what we explain to high school students, why dual credit can be such a great opportunity for them.
Yes.
But they're getting on board and they're getting registered, and
it's still,
registration is open now.
It's a wonderful opportunity, but it still grates me
that
40 years ago it was not available.
It
just gets to me. No, I'm so happy that it's available now, and I just, you know, I want more students to take advantage of this, because I think it is a wonderful opportunity.
It is a great opportunity. It's awesome.
Well, listen, I want to thank you for being with us today.
Well, thanks for having me.
For agreeing to come. You did want to come on.
I did. I did.
I must say that. So I want to have you on again and talk about this further, okay?
Sounds great. Well, thank you.
We'll be right back.
Not essential. Never let anyone tell you that again. Never doubt your abilities to make a difference. How do I know this about you? Because I'm a teacher. I am the one who will push you harder and farther than you could have ever imagined. Teach you things that you never thought possible. And if you will give me 100%, then I will stand shoulder to shoulder with you, and together we will change your future. MCC, find your wings.
Okay, and we have Miss Susan Johnson here. I'm so glad to get you on the show.
I'm so happy to be here.
I'm just saying, every time we there are always conflicts trying to get you, you know, because you are so busy. I know you are so busy.
I have a full life.
You have a full life, and you are the director of our Arts and Letters program.
I am.
Here at Meridian Community College, and you've been doing this for
just 2 years.
Two years.
You know, I got here COVID hit. I got here right before COVID hit, so I've never had a whole season.
Okay, yeah.
Because we all went home, and then we weren't sure what was going to happen last year, and kind of squeezed a lot into the second semester. Mm-hmm. But we have to be very careful to protect our college's reputation. Yes. And so we've done some things, but we haven't been able to really advertise and do them like we want to do them.
Right. Well, you know, one of the we are a community college, and I think arts and letters really is in the forefront of that because we offer so much for the community.
We try. I mean, we really try hard every day, and not just the arts and letters department, but as you know, our extended education, I mean, you know, our continuing education and all that.
Yes.
So
Now, what are some of the things that we have coming up? Can you share with us?
I can. I can finally share with you. And I do want to say that, first of all, arts and letters, we just, hot off the press, have this brochure that came out. And it's a little late because of COVID.
Right.
But in the back of the brochure, we have our mission, a short mission statement, which is MCC's Arts and Letters series serves as an open door between the college and the community, offering a diverse array of performances, lectures, and dialogue that celebrates all art forms. We educate, entertain, and inspire. And, you know, that dialogue and conversation is something that we're trying to really amp up with arts and letters. Mm-hmm. We've traditionally offered plays and some within the campus. We have a wonderful music department here,
yes,
but it's kind of been that and some plays. And we really want to start offering some different types of things, more on the letters side.
Okay.
So, right off the bat, we had a little bit of a preview show that we've already had, which was the Improvical Jokers.
Yes.
And it was so much fun. And just going to kind of throw in the fact that Arts and Letters now has Stage 2. A lot of people are familiar with the teen theater training group called Stage 2. It's part of MCC now.
Good.
And we talk about improv every single week in Stage 2. And that is what the Improvical Jokers are. They're an improv group, and they absolutely delighted our audience. You were there.
I was there, yes,
and it was so much fun. Our theater students loved it and have
been
springboarding off of that for the last 3 weeks. And then our first really big show we had this past week, which was Listen Here.
Yes.
And I'm going to bring it up because we want to do more of this, and a lot of people just are not familiar with these formats, where you bring in artists or writers, authors, and it's a little bit of a round table or a writers in the round or authors in the round, and we have a guest host. You did this for me for our first one when
yes.
we brought in a couple of authors.
Yes, had a really good time with that.
So it was so much fun.
It was a lot of fun.
You don't necessarily have to have read the book or listened to the songs that these artists are talking about. It's like watching a cool documentary mm-hmm. where you're like, I didn't know that went on behind. I didn't mm-hmm. know that's what a publishing deal meant.
Mm-hmm.
Our audience loved it. They asked questions,
yes.
Passed the time. And we actually brought three huge Nashville and Toronto songwriters that write across the genres.
Yes.
And they talked about their life. They talked about the songs. And then we had a masterclass. And we had aspiring songwriters come.
I bet that was wonderful.
It was so inspiring.
Yes.
That was great. So that's already happened. But the next thing we have coming up is the Christmas concert. I brought their brochure.
Yes.
And it's beautiful. It's just beautiful. Our MCC has a wonderful music department.
We really
and
do.
I have already had a little sneak listen to one of the a cappella pieces that the Dimensions group is doing. You don't want to miss this. This is real community. It's going to kick off on December 2nd, Thursday night, 7 o'clock, free. Come and be ready to be inspired to sing along a little bit and get ready for the season with that. And so that's going to happen in December.
Mm-hmm.
In January.
Yes, yes, yes.
We have Matilda Jr. Should I do this?
Yes.
Matilda Jr. is going to be, it's going to feature students who are in two of our MCC Arts and Letters acting groups. I talked to you about Stage 2, which is 13 through college. Take 1, we started last year. It's an after-school program for 8 to 12-year-olds. Some of them are 13, some of them are 14. We don't really care. We want you to come and love acting. They audition for the show. We have some people of interest who are in the show. We have a lot of our faculty has students who are in these groups. they're learning what hard work is.
Yes.
But I usually hear this, it's a lot of hard work, but it's fun.
Yes.
To have that much
My nephew is in it, and let me just say, I just must say, riding herd on, I go and I watch, and y'all do such an incredible job with like 20 or 30 kids
or
on
100.
Stage.
Or 100,
it
feels like 100.
It just seems like it. And y'all are getting them all here. I've never been a big picture kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just looking at it going, this is absolutely incredible. First off, I would be running for the hills, but y'all do such an incredible job. And my nephew is coming back, and he's at that age where he can't be too enthusiastic about stuff, especially to me.
Right.
But he is. That's all he talks about. He's just having such a good time.
It's a great opportunity to learn what real teamwork and what that collaborative effort that we talk about for the rest of our lives as adults, mm-hmm. that we need to learn how to work with other people. Some of the older ones learn what it's like to try to be good role models.
Mm-hmm.
We all go into self-control position when Miss Susie says get in self-control position, because some of our children are still learning how to keep their hands to themselves,
yeah.
as you can see when you come watch. But that's okay. We love them. I have a team of volunteers who they love these students too. They believe
incredible.
In what
they're
we do.
Absolutely incredible.
And we work them very hard. We do not just stand up there and sing these songs. We're singing and we're acting and we're learning. And it's a great program. But all that to say, it is going to take place end of January. It's a 1 hour, it's Matilda Jr., which means it's a shorter version of a Broadway show. And so that is January 22nd and 23rd right here at the McCain Theater. And those are both going to be afternoon performances at 3 o'clock.
Okay.
Come, watch, go celebrate. I can't wait to tell you about this is another book look.
Okay.
Harrison Scott Key, who is an incredible award-winning author and humorist, is going to be here. Same kind of format as we did with the music, where he's going to sit on the stage, he is going to talk, he will take questions and answers from the audience. He has written two really phenomenal books, very, very funny books. One is called The World's Largest Man. That's his latest, and I think it's a memoir of his life with his father.
Mm-hmm.
But our humanities faculty is already very excited about this.
Good.
Really want to encourage faculty to support these and to support by encouraging / requiring your students to come to these, because they won't regret it.
No.
Lauderdale County School is going to be doing Moana on our stage, and we have the Dimensions in the spring who will be doing a show. And then we are going to be partnering with the Jimmy Rogers Foundation and Festival to present the Blue Yodeler.
Oh my.
I'll be directing that. It's a smaller, it was here before, but it's the life of Jimmy Rogers. People are going to be coming from out of state to mm-hmm. that. And then we end with stage two's Annie Get Your Gun in June.
Oh my.
We have a full season. Yay, finally.
Finally. I cannot wait. I cannot wait. We are out of time.
I'm sure I'm talking over the time.
No. I want to have you back. I want to talk about all of this again.
Uh-huh.
I appreciate you being here.
Thank you for having me.
As I said, I just watch you run herd, and it's amazing. It's absolutely amazing.
Well, it's all worth it.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
We'll be right back.
Since 1996, the MCC Foundation Tuition Guarantee Program has provided students an opportunity to find their potential. Thousands of students have benefited from the program. Over $6 million have been invested in the students who learn and live right here in our community. This program is funded by individuals and businesses who believe in our students, our families, and the economic impact of an education at Meridian Community College. Now is your chance to offer support. Give today at meridiancc.edu/give.
On behalf of executive producer Matt Milner, media consultant Josh Taylor, and student producer Ronnie Reese, thank you for watching. We hope you learned one or two things. See you next week.